Okay, this is the second episode of Boring Ben Videos. Now, I just wanted to have a go at understanding how this works properly. And I've hooked it up to the analog discovery. And you can see my mouse. I have, just a moment. Shift it. Be shifted over. I have logged up the logic analyzer, so I've got AB, which is the A and B's out of the pot. A pulse, which is here. After here, we have the little, out of this logic gate here. B pulse, which is out of this logic gate. They're just the little pulses relating to the rise and the fall of A and B of the quadrature encoder. And then the OR, which is where it's ORed here. And I've also got the XOR output here. So you can see it working. And the actual most interesting part is you can see how it works is, let me try and capture it. Is that, how do you select that? That when B leads, the pulse is slightly beyond, because it's a XOR of the delayed signal, so it's the XOR of the delayed signal here and just the regular A, the delayed B and the regular A, the pulse here is slightly before, yeah, and then when it's the other way, it's quite hard to see when it's the other way, so you see here that B is lagging before and A is leading, then you'll see the pulse is slightly in front of the X or AB, this one. So what that means is when you put it into this flip-flop, if we're going in one direction, we'll detect one direction, and if we do the other, we'll detect backwards, forward and backwards, basically. Now, I think I've discovered why we're getting some misreadings, and I think that's because, if you look at this data sheet, it says that the flip-flop, is it the clock? Where's the clock? Minimum clock pulse width is 70 to 140 nanoseconds. And our, if I can pick it up again, our pulse width, I can measure it. There. Wait. Stop. No. So there is 70 microseconds. Okay. Just about right, but it might be why occasionally we're having errors. So I can actually probably fix that by. I'm going to try and increase the resistor in the RC by 10. See what happens. So I've got these 10. Got these 10 10 kilo ohm resistors. Stick them in. Turn off the power. It might be a bit hard because I've got all these probes in here. Going a bit over the top. Maybe it's too much, but let's see. I'm multiplying. The pulse time should be multiplied by 10. Maybe I should just use 2k. See what happens. Actually, maybe this will be too long. They're going to be huge. Let's see what they look like. Oh, they're not massive. Interesting. Wait. Oh, we're getting like a extra glitch. No, our B pulses are still quite small. Go away, other stuff. Why are B pulses so small? Is it worse now? Yeah. Interesting that it's worse. And our B pulse doesn't look like it's changed at all. Why is B not changed? Oh, I put the wrong resistor in. There we go. The glitching effect is worse. You can see a little glitch in the output. I might put another probe in. Put another logic probe in. Let's look at the direction output. Which is there. I'll have to put new signal in, which is 6. It's called direction. Can't see any glitches, but what if I... Oh, there's a little one. Oh, stop. See here. Here. It didn't. It glitched here. Interestingly, we're missing the last pulse here. So it's like the B pulse went missing. I thought I was seeing the bulb flick. It's not flickering though, you can definitely. Is it? Come on. I kind of just want. I'm not familiar enough with this. There's a couple. So here we had a brief, I was only turning it in one direction, but we got a brief glitch where it went low. Weirdly, when B went high. And then it went back high again, but I can't really see. It seemed to go back high again when the A fell, but yeah, because it's kind of a random. They're rising at the same time, but the falling is weird because the clock. If you look, the clock sets at the rising point. So it fell, which means it's red of four. I wonder if it's. No, I can't work it out. I wonder if. I'm just going to move on, but there is something strange happening. I can't see. Because. This is falling here, but I can't really see where, at what rising edge, because it's the XOR here where it records, and it shouldn't have picked up a fall here, because at this rising edge it was high. Could be something to do with, I haven't actually got everything here is actually unconnected. I might be creating problems. It's obviously getting little triggers from somewhere. We just can't see them. Seems to be worse now. If I put it back, pulses are smaller. Seems a bit better. But not completely gone. Wondering whether we're getting crosstalk or something from the gates that are unhooked, because I can't see in the something's gone wrong then. That's not right. B pulse, A pulse is not right. What have I done there? Touching something, yeah, it's touching something. I just want to have if I'm running it when I stop occasionally. You have to do it fast. Sometimes it actually goes low. That's fine. That's not fine. Yeah, because let's read a low. I wonder if this... clockwise is meant to be high. Put it on... quite a good mode. Yeah. Got the resolution. So here, I was only turning clockwise. Wait, no. Let me record a good one. There you go. I was only turning clockwise. Oh, wait, no. Wait. Here we go. I had to do it. I had to rotate again, otherwise it loses this bit of data. So it went low because the clock was low. Because it's A leading, and A doesn't... Yeah, that's not right. Because on a good one... That was a good one. Oh, wait. Set off. No. On a good one, see, it remains high. Yeah, because it's where... should be here. Why is the pulse, why is this pulse suddenly shifting when it shouldn't be? Because, oh, B is leading. So B leads on clockwise. You just put it on repeated. And anti-clockwise, B trails, A leads, so when, yeah, clockwise, B leads, so B, it'll be high, yeah, so how come occasionally it's wrong? Okay, let's try that again. Wrong one, and it's not there. There's a glitch. What? They touching. Yep, they're touching. I need a better way to see a mistake. Oh, look there. It seems to be related to the way I turn the knob. I can't quite tell it. Occasionally I get glitches. I can't... I need to work on that, but I'm going to move on. Because what I want to do is use a... CD... A binary up down counter. I think it's the 4 428. Is it the 4516? No. I've got two. It's the 2-8. No, it's this one. 4029. And
it's the space.
4029. Oh. It's the little jumper stuck in there. So I've got the 4029, and I want the binary. Yeah, it's the 4028. The binary to octal to decimal decoder. Should be here. Just looking for it in. I think I bought two of them. I've got the 4029. Where did I put? 4-0. So wait, are they still in the tube? I thought I pulled everything out. 4-0-5 ones. And I did have a random tube. I can't remember if I... Wait a minute. Nope, another 4029. Where's the 428s? Oh well. let's just start on this. So the 4029. Old photocopy of an old RCA. So power is 16. Ground is 8. We want to put our clock. No, our up down, which is the same as where the LED is. Things, I think it might be a bit glitchy. So our clock is, no, our up down is 10. So that's 8, 9, 10. Now a clock. I only want the falling edge. When do I want it to change? So if we run this, what is it running? Oh, it's not running. Get it to be. I think I might move the trigger to. No, that's not trigger. Yeah, that's trigger. Move the trigger to the pulse. Mixed pulse. The odd triggers. What happens then? Oh, I just can't see anything. Can't see. Oh, this is gone again. Not again. That's probably why it wasn't working. There you go. I see it. So I've got the three. So I have these three triggers, but I don't want to feed that into my clock, so I'll move three times. I only need the first. Why are we missing the full pulse? Why are we missing the full pulse? We should have a pulse for both. Might just because I'm not zoomed in enough. Yeah, there it is. So if we're going forwards, backwards, why is it not? Why is direction not working? Direction. Some reason direction's not working. Oh, I plugged it into there and it stopped working. That's working. See, we don't want a clock pulse. If we're going clockwise, our direction isn't set. No, our direction's set just after the rising edge of A. It's going anticlockwise, direction set just after the rising B. We don't want to use clock because we'd have four clocks then otherwise. And it's always decided by the first pulse. Occasionally we get a glitch on the last pulse. So if it's always decided on by the first pulse, then we just need a lead and edge. But on, don't want to do it there because we can't use this because there'd be two pulses there. Shit. So how am I gonna get a decent clock? I guess I could divide this by four. But it would have to be in sync. Just thinking. I just want one pulse. I did it on A. No. thing is, when it's going in one direction, I want it to be on the... I don't really want to have to... I could use a flip-flop. I'd still have double the... Ah, this is interesting. I don't actually have a proper pulse that represents one click on the... control. Could use the falling pulse. How can I get just a falling pulse? Say if I just got the falling pulse of A, it's always going to be beyond. Yeah. Whereas I can't use the rising pulse because that is a metastable area. All the falling pulse of B, doesn't matter. But it always seems to change direction, it always should change direction at the first. Oh, wait a minute. No. I can't use the direction pin because it doesn't always change. How do I get just the falling diode? I have a spare XOR. So, I simulate the idea. If I look at this in the scope, oh, I should be doing it on A. It doesn't really matter, A or B is fine. Current. So I could do what gates have I got left? XORs. I could use an XOR between B. Output. No, that's not right. Oh yeah, because then... No, that's weird. I want it to be... Wait. Start again. want it to be. That's the pulse. That's B. But they're changing at the same time. So I can't really do that. I think that's enough for now. This was extra boring. Thanks, bye.